I've always been overweight. I was always the big kid and never really let it bother me, I guess. But especially when I hit high school, definitely heard some comments and some nicknames that that people gave me. I didn't get on a scale in high school. I didn't get on a scale in junior high. I just didn't care. It didn't make a difference, and I just was big. I put myself down a lot, I think, because I felt like if I put myself down, then if anybody else did it, it didn't hurt as much because I'd already done it. But it got worse in college. I remember going to an amusement park in Texas and getting on a roller coaster and being so excited to ride and sitting down and not being able to fit in the car. And that was embarrassing. I was so ashamed. I had pushed away the thought, the notion of being healthy. I didn't really care, and I always used the excuse that obesity ran in my family. We were all overweight, and I hid behind that a lot. Fast forward to, we move up to North Carolina. God calls us up here to Independence Hill. We realize Angels has PCOS. She has insulin resistance, which causes this PCOS, which also causes her to be considered pre-diabetic. And this all happens within the first 6 months we live in Charlotte. So the doctor, her doctor tells her she needs to go to the diabetes center and get some education. And Angela really wants me to go with her and is concerned for my health and wants me to do a part of this. I, at this point, still didn't care. I just hadn't connected and make a difference. I'd sit down and watch Biggest Loser while eating a huge meal from Taco Bell. And when I mean a huge meal, I mean probably 6 to 8 items. Just this complete dichotomy of who I should be, who I'm watching I should be on TV. These guys are and girls are striving for health and who I am and what I eat. So we go to the diabetes center and I see the impact of what obesity and then type 2 diabetes has on you and the health that it just takes away from you. And from a physical standpoint, it clicked. And I can only equate making the decision, the initial decision to begin losing weight, to the decisions of following Christ, and then secondly, asking Angela to be my wife. Aside from those two decisions, making the decision to lose weight is the deepest rooted decision I've ever made. I went and saw my doctor, and told him what I wanted to do, told him my goal, and this was in January of 2010. My goal was to lose 100 pounds by the time I turned 30, which was 9 months away. And he said, you know, given your age, I believe that's a healthy goal for you to attain. I began to exercise, and that was huge. In May, we have our 5K, and I signed up for the 5K, and I began to walk from where we lived at the time up to the church. It was about 2 miles. And it was amazing that I was able to do that. I didn't know I was able to walk 2 miles. I'd never done that before. And I'll never forget, on the 5K itself, Justin Hendershot ran with me the entire way. And most of the time we walked, but we ran some spots, but it was great. And we hit the final stretch on Arthur Davis Road. And he's like, come on, let's run the whole thing. And I'm thinking, sure, no problem, not that far. That road gets longer if you run it. And if it hadn't been for him by my side, yelling at me, come on, Tim, you can do it, you can do it, you can do it, I would have stopped. But as it was, I finished by running in the 5K, and that was a feeling I'd never felt before. And it was awesome. And that same weekend that I finished the 5K, that same weekend I found out I was gonna be a dad. And to find that kind of victory all at once was almost a little too much. I began to see a bigger picture of why I was losing weight. It wasn't just for me to lose weight. It was because God was preparing me to be a father. He was preparing me to take care of somebody else when I couldn't at 340 pounds or 325 pounds, whatever I started at. And the weight loss continued. And I, at this point, I have lost 130 pounds. And it doesn't matter what point of life you're in, if you're 29 or you're 89 or you're somewhere in between, you can make the decision to lose weight, to get healthy.